Brichem Aboim, welcome back to our 10th Shiur together, Baruch Hashem. We've accomplished so many Shiurim and we've already reached into the next level of digits, into the 10th Shiur. And Emet Hashem, I would like to be able to continue coming up with many different topics. And I'm encouraging you to be able to come back to me with different ideas that you might have, that you're thinking about, that you would like that we can discuss together. And of course, I could prepare or something we can come up together with different ideas that we can present. A limud, something that we can learn together and something we would be able to take a lot out from it. So this week I was thinking about the four Parshios. We just had the first this past Shabbos, which was Parshas Shkolim, which we'll just speak a little bit about. And we'll discuss all the four Parshios. Now, first of all, preparing this shiur, I was learning a lot about yesterday. Therefore, I made a shiur today rather than yesterday because there was a lot really to look into it. And I think many of us just stand through the Yetzirahs, go through the whole entire Shabbos with a little bit of a very vague understanding of really what it's really all about. And once again, this shiur, it's not necessarily intended to really go into great detail about all the topics we're discussing, but just a general basic idea, just to have it on the top of our minds, what it is and how we can go about it, just knowing about it. And once again, is that now I want to be able to just put together of a basic idea of what it is, why we have such parshiyos like this. But I do want to mention that each one of the parshiyos, we start with Shkolim, Zachar, Para, Chodesh, each one carry a tremendous amount of detail, and a lot of mafarshim explain a lot on each one of the parshiyos. With that being said, I just want to just open up with first the famous Mishnah in Masechtas Megillah, Pidek Gimel Mishnah Dalid, which basically just writes about these four, about Rosh Chodesh Uda Shechol Liyos B'Shabbos, Koyrin Parshas Shkolim, Chol Liyos B'Soicha Shabbos, Magdimin Shalodah, Mavsikin L'Shabbos Acheres, Shebishnia, like we just said, is Zachar, Bashlishis is Parah Aduma, Bereviyas is HaChodesh Hazeh Lechem, and then afterwards, Chamishis, Chozrin L'Chisidron, and it finishes off the Mishnah. So going back really to the beginning, what we were discussing was these four parshiyos are of course special parshiyos, and they're dedicated to this specific time, to the time of the Chodesh Adar, the Chodesh Nisan, that has to do with Purim, which has to do with Pesach. And the truth of the matter is that even Purim itself really has a great connection into Pesach. Because we know, hopefully maybe we'll do it maybe next week, a little more about the halachas of Purim, about the entire day. But one of the halachas is that we need to go ahead and start learning about the hilchas of Pesach, because it's Shleshim Yom Kodem Lachag. And we'll speak about it maybe just next week, maybe the following week, about more Purim ideas. But there's a tremendous connection between Udar and Pesach. We want to connect. That's why we know on a leap year we have that there's two others. We put Purim closest, the other that's closest to Pesach, because we want them both connect, both the Yitzias, the Mitzrayim, to the Gullus, to the Geilah. We want to be able to connect them both, which is a different topic. But once again, is that both these times together are very much connected, and therefore all these parshiyos are put together. But each one of the parshiyos are contained with that has to do more with Purim, that has to do more with Pesach. So let's first start with Shabbos Shkolim, which we had last week. Of course, we know that it's because of the Machas HaShekel. We discussed that in Parshas Kisiso. Parshas Kisiso just speaks about how when every single person comes to the Beis HaMikdash, we're supposed to be able to give tzedakah toward the Machas HaShekel. That's what we want every single person to do. We want the rich people, we want the poor people. Doesn't matter who you are, you're all going to be able to give that same amount. A Machas HaShekel of a certain tzedakah that we want to be able to everyone have, whether you have money, whether you don't have money, it doesn't really matter who you are. Everyone collectively is being able to give a portion to be able to give toward tzedakah. And that's what Shkolim is really all about. And we have even Tanis Esther. There's a need to go give a machas shekel on Tanis Esther, all because of the same idea, is that here during this time of Chodesh Udar, we go and we Tonight's Rosh Chodesh Adar and Metz Hashem, we're going to call out, we're going to reserve who, how that's going to be, and who is going to be appointed to be able to make that happen, is all the Shchedesh Ruder. So the Shabbos before the Shchedesh Ruder, like the Mishnah says, is that if it falls out on Shabbos, then actually the Shchedesh Ruder is really the time when we find that we take our three Sifrei Torahs, because then we have, Halacha says that we have Shabbos, we have Rosh Chodesh, and then we have for the Shkalim. It works like that with by Parshas HaChodesh also. We find that sometimes Shabbos comes out of Rosh Chodesh, we take out three Sefer Torahs. But typically, just on these Shabbos, we're taking out an extra special Torah to be able to line from these parts of the Torah where we find about Machas HaShechah, where we find about Shabbos Zachar, which I'm going to explain in 1 second, is about the Mechias HaMalek, and then we're going into Paro, which is the Paro Aduma, and then the Chodesh, which is about the Chodeshim. So once again, so that's really Parashas Shkolim, even though we had it already, just a basic idea about why we're doing it now, why we're doing it right before the Chodesh Uder. The next one, like we just said, is Parashas Zachar, which is coming up, not this coming Shabbos, but the following Shabbos, which is always falls out to be the Shabbos before Purim, is one of the, well, actually, Zachar and Par is really machlokes, whether it's considered a daraisa or not. Zachar is definitely is written in the Torah. What does the Torah say? Parshas Zachar is found in Parshas Ki Tse. Parshas Ki Tse, at the end of Parshas Ki Tse, we find the part where we're remembering Amalek, but the whole idea is that the pasuk says, Mamash, the last words in Parshas Ki Tse, is Timche Zecher Amalek Mitachas Hashamayim Leitzishkach. You have to wipe it out, you have to totally erase out the whole Zecher of Amalek, the whole memory of Amalek from Mitachas Hashamayim Leitzishkach, and you should not forget. So it's just interesting Lashon is how that's played out, because you should remember not to forget. So what does that mean? So that means is that we have to constantly keep on our mind that is something that we don't want to have sitting on our heads. That's what we want to make sure that we're constantly reminding ourselves. So that's the Zachar, that's the remembrance of Amalek. And of course it has to do with the whole story of Purim, with Haman, who was a descendant of Amalek. And therefore Torah writes it, that it's something we have to be able to always remember, every time, always. It says Loy Sishkach means for all time. And so that's Parshas Zachar. Once again, it's a daraisa that we need to be able to listen to it. And of course, as you know, most Bote Medroshim, when they're saying Parshas Zachar, there's a difference of the Lashon, is exactly how to pronounce the word Zecher Amalek. So sometimes they say Zecher, sometimes it's Zecher. And most shiurs, I think everyone might have a different way of going about it, but most places will either repeat the pusuk again, or maybe they say the word twice. But everyone's going to make sure that they want to be able to get that daraisa clear. Make sure they're mimikayim the mitzvah daraisa of remembering Amalek, to make sure we wipe it out from our existence of life, of knowing that we have any remembrance or any connection toward that type of way of life. Moving along, just quickly, I want to wrap up just with the last two. Again, this is after Purim. This is the Parshas Para, which of course has to do with the Para Aduma, which again, like we said before, is already post Purim, which is already getting into the time of Shloshim Kodem Lachag for Pesach. So therefore, the Para Aduma, which in the times of Beis Hamikdash was part of the spiritual cleansing process of allowing ourselves to be able to be zeicher of the cleanliness of being able to come into the Yom Tov of Pesach. We want to be able to go and, of course, now take this Pasha and Parshas Para and to read in Parshas Chikas, where it speaks about the Para Aduma. Once again, lastly is Parshas HaChodesh, which comes before Rosh Chodesh Nisan. As we know that the pusuk in Parshas Bo, which is what we read on Parshas HaChodesh, comes from HaChodesh Hazeh Lachem Rosh Chodashim. Is that this is one of the first mitzvahs that Klal Yisrael received once they were in Mitzrayim, to create months to be able to make a chodesh for yourself, and that's what we're going to do now, right before Rosh Chodesh Nisan, the month preparing for the Yom Tov of Pesach, to go ahead and to dedicate this last final of the four Shabbosim, dedicated to the Parshios Chodesh. And I hope we were able to just enlighten you a little bit about what these four Parshios are, and why we dedicate extra tefillas, and why we dedicate extra an extra aliyah toward taking out another Sefer Torah for these one of these four Parshios. And emet Hashem, we should be able to be zeicher to be able to go through Simchas of Mishnichnas Udar Mabim B'Simcha, and we should be able to take that Simcha ultimately into the Chodesh of Nisan, into the Chodesh of the Geilah, with Mashiach Tzedekayne B'Mahayda V'Yamani Umayim.